Thanks for joining me. A certain website was hacked and the very personal data of a lot of people was released and made public. As a result, some people lost their jobs and others lost a lot more. Now, in general, the attitude that surfaced in the media was that these guys got what they deserved. These people, it was believed, had acted badly. Society has a bipolar relationship with immorality. A provocatively dressed starlet turns up at an awards show and acts outrageously, and people say, well, that's just her being her. The internet is crawling with off-color stuff. It's all over TV. The supermarket has magazines at the checkout with headlines on the cover. You don't want your kids to read. You don't want you to read. And nobody seems to mind too terribly. Statistics suggest a lot of people are acting unfaithfully. As many marriages as ever are falling apart. The media continues to glorify immorality. So the question really has to be asked, as a society, are we against immoral behavior or not? When a website is hacked and it's found that millions of men have been doing exactly what society has been urging them to do, why is anyone surprised or outraged? Or to flip it around, if it's really bad that people are caught doing this, why isn't it bad when all of that shameful behavior that goes on around us turns up in a thousand different ways? The Bible has always said this, 1 Thessalonians 4, verses 3 and 4. For this is the will of God, even your sanctification, that you should abstain from fornication, that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel in sanctification and honor. If sin is sinful at all, then it's always sinful. God calls us to purity, and he can keep you pure if you'll let him. If you're tempted morally in any way, you need to know God can deliver you. God's principles of purity are for all time. When they're followed, the family, in fact, all of society, is better off. Let's live today by every word.